What?
Alkish, Janshe, Alkish. Schaefer, Bigge.
Holy shit.
And here comes a freaking tank.
Okay, I know I may be hallucinating here, but was that an old guy humping a lady in the background?
No.
I just saw, like, this guy humping something in the background. I'm not even kidding.
The guy in the pinkish shirt?
Yeah.
Pinkish red? No, that was Schaefer. He was, like, crouched behind cover. Ow! I just got hit by a tank blast.
I saw someone humping something.
I'll have to look at that in the footage later, but pretty sure you were just seeing things.
If that was Schaefer, Schaefer would be like, "I'm so horny."
Okay, keep moving. Oh my gosh. At least I lived that time. Tenzin! Get the door open. I just said that, Drake. Oh, I have one bullet in my AK-47. Now I don't. Oh, hi, tank! Bye, tank!
I'm glad somebody likes my bad jokes.
I know Aerie likes them.
She said that her weakness is guys who love, bad puns.
Oh! Sounds like you got a girlfriend.
Hard to believe.
I'm kidding, dude.
But yeah, so you have a little bit of a crush on her. But
I know Aerie's already taken, right?
I don't know.
Oh. Begin! La 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 la. I'm just going to run through the area. Oh, I got a medal. Sweet. Yay! It's not gonna save me, though!
Okay. Ow! Ow!
And now we run. Aww, I didn't make it.
RPG tends. How do you say RPG in Tibetan?
It's Tibetan for RPG.
I just said that, Drake.
Up ladder!
Up and over.
Wrong place, wrong time, Mr. Mercenary. What's up, buddy? Oh. Thanks, Tenzin.
Did you just kick him in the nuts?
No, I was punching him and then I think Tenzin shot him. Go. Drake!
Tanks.
Get up! Drake, get up! Run!
Thanks a lot. Thanks for the memories.
Thanks for the treasure. Uh-oh.
And I can see Victor going, Spirit, enough with the puns!
Yeah!
While Ares is laughing her little fuzzy butt off.
Ah! I'm telling you, the shotgun guys in this game are the bane of my existence when playing Uncharted. They hurt so bad.
Victor hates my puns, and Ares is laughing at them.
Well, I gotta admit, Victor's jokes and puns are way better than yours.
Hey, what do you call a team of musical...
Oh, I just shot him right in the balls! Did you see that? Desert 5 to the balls. Ow!
I did not see that.
At least I think I shot him in the balls.
So he had the same thing that happened
to me. Oh crap, I'm out of ammo.
So basically he had the same thing that happened to me.
Well, when you're out of ammo, all you can do is this.
Yeah. Hey. Whoa. Wait, what do you call a team of musical orcas? An orchestra.
I was gonna say an orchestration, but I guess that's... Yeah, I get it.
Airy was the one that came up with that one.
I think I know where to go.
Did he just try to hump the wall?
I don't think so. Is there a treasure down here, or am I thinking of another level? I must be thinking of something else.
Tenzin!
You know, for some unknown reason, and I still don't know why, whoa, this level is making, like, reminding me about that time we went to the zoo, and my nephew Dean and Jamie were with their class, and on going on the same field trip, but it was a different school.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, you know all about the story about the elephant passing gas.
Yeah, you could hear it echoing throughout the entire zoo. It was such a massive fart.
It's like we were going and getting ready to go through the monkey exhibit, and we had to group up with the kids from Disney, which is where my niece and nephew, my nephews were going at that time.
Mm-hmm.
So we gripped up with them and figured why not, because, you know, speed numbers and everything. So me and Dean, at that time, because Jamie wasn't born yet, I think. No, wait, Jamie was born. He was 8. And Dean, I believe, was 9? I don't know. But anyways, we were going through the monkey exhibit, and, like, we see through the...
Oh, crap! Oh.
Ow! Talked about getting tanked. But we had to pass through the monkey exhibit, and because the back exit was blocked off because an elephant was pregnant...
Mm-hmm.
They go through the back way and enter through the elephant exhibit. And... was positioned, because the back entrance was closed, we had to go the long way.
Hmm.
Because you don't want to go near a pregnant elephant. They are extremely aggressive when they're pregnant, because obviously, big freaking animal, big freaking pain. You know, gonna be really, really ticked off. Just like if you poke a pregnant woman with a stick.
So you'll likely get a punch to the face.
Exactly.
Ah!
Boing!
This tank, I'm telling you.
But, anyways, we had to pass through. And all of a sudden, like, we were hearing this... like, I cannot make an elephant sound, but it's like an elephant trumpeting.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden... like, really, like, thunderously loud, about 50 seconds long.
Dang.
And it was way longer than your Coach Poyser fart and my John B. Hughes apartment's fart. Together, all in one. And the kids were just laughing really, really hard. Because, obviously, kids love farts. We all do.
Well, we love fart humor, too. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I can admit it's one of the most immature forms of humor ever, yet I find it hilarious. And, ow, I just got owned by a rocket.
But we were laughing our full heads off.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't until the smell hit us. Imagine the worst smell of Limburger cheese, rotten egg farts, cabbage farts.
You know, I've never smelt Limburger cheese. I have smelt rotten egg farts, though.
Limburger cheese sort of smells like a mixture between hot and spicy, but salty and spice, salty and peppery. But it's, like, stinky. Like sulfur smell.
Mm-hmm.
Now imagine all those smells combined, but amplified so hard that you can actually taste it.
Yeah.
Physically taste it.
That's terrible.
And actually see the methane. That is what was going on. We could actually physically smell it. And the smell lasted the entire trip.
Oh crap, he's still alive. Okay.
And to give you an example on how bad that smelled, we could smell it even when going back into the school bus.
Oh crap, I didn't grab the zip line! Oh no. Wait, if I'm really lucky, I can still make this.
Whee!
Oh, no way.
How?
No way! I beat the tank. I cannot believe I just survived that. That was so lucky.
Tenzin!
Hello!
Bima! Quincho King! Schaefer! Where's Schaefer?
We can't see you still.
Maybe Donut Drake should have sat on it.
Donut Drake just falls out of the sky like boom!
I can imagine you putting that into the bloopers, like Donut Drake jumps on it and you edit it so that it like makes that scene.
It pulled off a pull. He pulled off a pulverizing pancake. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. It's actually a new move in Pokemon, Sun and Moon. They were talking about it on a Nintendo Direct the other day. Basically, there's a Z-Stone thing you can give to a Snorlax, which gives it an ability called Pulverizing Pancake. It literally, like, falls out of the sky and just lands on and flattens the opponent. That's what I can imagine Donut Drake doing.
Just reminded me, this college in England, I kid you not, and you can look it up for yourself, has actually been trying to turn their college into a full, legally licensed, and fully funded school of Hogwarts.
Really?
I kid you not.
Wow.
I'll even send you the link after all of this to prove it to you.
Alright. I'm hanging! I'm hanging!
Get this, J.K. Rowling approves it.
Oh, wow. By the way, is it true she's making another Harry Potter book?
Yeah.
Look, I stopped reading Harry Potter a long time ago, but I thought he died at the end of Deathly Hallows Part 2. Like, how could she make another one?
He almost died.
Oh, I was hearing that he died at the end. Like, so many people were talking about it and reporting it.
What happened was, now keep in mind this wasn't part of the script, but, David Radcliffe, yeah. During the scene where, like, he was doing the final duel, he almost broke his arm in half.
Oh.
I mean, he was okay, he was fine, but, you know, that's where everyone thought he almost died, because, you know, he just snapped his arm. You know, that's it. That's the only real serious injury he had. But he was okay. It's like, it's okay, guys, chill, I'm fine. I just dislocated my elbow.
I wasn't talking about the movie, I was talking about the book. I never even saw the movie. Heck, I haven't seen any Harry Potter movies in a long time.
I like the...
Oh, whoa, that was close.
The only parts about the last two movies I think was kind of a stupid move is when Hermione wipes out the memories of her parents.
Wait, what movie did this happen in?
Deathly Hallows Part 1.
I've never seen it.
Like, hello? I mean, yes, I get it. You want to protect your parents from Voldemort, but don't you ever think that, you know, your parents might go away for 15 years because they, you know, the law might... You know, think, okay, your daughter is mysteriously gone and you have no memory of her? Shocking! It's like, I get it that it's not really J.K. Rowling's fault she wasn't the one that directed it, but you think J.J. Abrams or whoever it was that directed the movies would at least think that through.
Mm-hmm. Well, I have no idea what you're talking about, because like I said, I never saw the movie or even read the book.
Well, basically, in Deathly Hallows Part 1, Hermione casts a spell and her parents wipe out their memories.
You okay back there?
Yeah. There's the lead car. Gun it.
Hold on.
We're going to end real soon, by the way, because... I know you need to leave at about 6, and it's like 3 minutes till right now.
Yeah.
Which is good timing, actually, because I think this is like the end of this chapter, too. Convoy's a really short chapter.
Oh yeah, there's no way they survived that. Let's go.
And yet somehow they did.
Of course they survived.
Come on.
Seriously, how did they survive that? How did they get out of the Jeep and then climb up the cliff?
Probably fell out.
So now what?
Maybe there was a lower cliff there.
We head to the creepy old monastery.
You know, I never really noticed this until now. She had a ponytail this whole time.
Yeah, she's always had a ponytail.
Didn't notice that until just now. I feel like a dork.
Has him.
Oh no. Ugh.
You ready for this?
As I'll ever be.
Hmm.
I guess this right here would be a good place to end for now. We are at 74%. Oh, yes, I want to save. By the way, I know it auto-saves, but I don't know. I always have a habit of just manually saving anyway.
Yeah, it's good to do that, just in case if you walk yourself into a place that you might find yourself really, really screwed, and that way you can just reload that file.
Mm-hmm.
I myself have fallen one too many times, fallen victim to a scenario like that.
Yup.
Booga booga!
Almost there. You got it?
Uh-huh.
I quietly...
Ooh, soft.
I guess we'll go ahead and let this scene play out first. Nice view. Oh no, I was talking about the mountains. Really. Come on, Drake. We know what you're talking about.
Well, she does have a nice butt.
Yep. There's a save again. I don't know if we'll have to watch that again, but we'll see. Oh, wait, hey, it says 75%. Okay, I guess that accounted for 1% then. Alright, yeah, we'll save here then. Well, anyway, next time we put an end to Lazarevich's plans, maybe.
See you guys next episode.
Not next episode, but like next recording session we might finish Uncharted 2. Anyway, see you guys.
See you guys.